Hey friends, welcome back to another week of church. I'm so excited you're here. Let's stand up and worship together.
Up in the morning and I wiggle my toes, oh. I stretch out my arms and I'm scratching my nose.
Great job singing and dancing, everybody. I hope you enjoyed moving around and dancing and singing with your family. Now we're going to do our memory verse. But first, can you remind me who made you? That's right, God made you. And we're talking about that all month long. Why God made you and the ways that He has given you special things about you that were used, oh no. Can you tell me who made you? That's right, God made you. And our memory verse is talking all about that. So let's do it together. Are you standing up? Are you ready? Here we go. I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Psalms 139:14. Let's do it one more time together. I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Psalms 139:14. Great job, you guys. Now we're gonna go to the playhouse and learn more about our story. And today we're talking about how important you are to God. We're gonna learn more about why we're important to God and how much He loves us. So let's go check in with Ollie and our friends at the playhouse.
Who? Who? You know what time it is?
It's time to hear a story.
I'm hanging up these awesome pictures of my friends. It makes me so happy to look at them. Do you like looking at pictures? I do too! Lucy looks so happy in this picture. All I had to do was say cheese, and she would start smiling and laughing. What a great day. And here's one of Peyton. Say cheese, Peyton. And Julia. And Mariah? When I told Mariah to say cheese, guess what I noticed? noticed. She lost the tooth. She was super excited that day.
Who? Who?
It's Ollie!
Hello, Zoe. Who? Who? Hanging up photos, are you?
Hi, Ollie. I sure am. I have all these amazing photos of my friends that remind me how important they are to me. I love them all so much.
Loving your friends is great. It's true. God loves all of them, too. Just listen to this story. Just follow me through. Who? Who?
Follow me through.
I'm Casey, and I'm helping out at the cupcake food truck. Want to see today's special? Ta-da! They're my wild watermelons. They kind of look like they have hair, don't they? That reminds me, you came for a story. If you're ready, on the count of three, yell, tell me a story. One, two, three! Tell me a story! Today's true story from the Bible. Whoa! What is that? It's very hairy. Can you tell what it is? I think it's an animal? Let's zoom out. It's a bunny! Whoa! So much hair. Okay, that was fun. Let's do it again! What kind of animal could this be? Maybe a grizzly bear? Or a horse? Let's see. It's a llama! That's awesome! Now, check out this creature. This one might be the hairiest of them all! What do you think, wild buffalo? Let's see. It's a kid! Wow! Look at all that hair! Did you know the Bible teaches that God knows how many hairs are on your head? It's true! Every single one. Can you even imagine counting this person's hair? And yet God knows exactly how many hairs are on his head. He even knows if one hair falls out onto his shirt. He knows. And do you know what that means for you? It means you are important to God. It's true. You are so important to God. No matter where you go, you're important to God when you're at the dentist. You're important to God when you're in timeout. You're important to God even when you're asleep. You're important to God when you're in the front of the line or anywhere in the line. You're important to God when you're sad or happy or mad or even silly. Isn't that wonderful? We are important to God. He made each and every one of us. Did you like that story? If you did, give it two thumbs up. Two thumbs up. Oh, hey, Ollie, tell me, who made you?
God made me. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, who made you?
God made me. That's the truth, friends. You better believe it. See you next time.
So there's your story. It's all true. We are important to God. He made and he loves you.
Thanks, Ollie.
Goodbye to you. Who? Who?
Wow, that's so awesome. God made each of us and we're important to him. My friends are important to me and they're important to God. I think I got the story. Did you get it? If you did, say got it. Get it?
Got it!
Good. Hey, I have an idea. How about I take a picture of you with your biggest smile? Are you ready? Say cheese. Wow, you guys did great. Super job, everyone. I'll see you guys later. Goodbye.
friends, you are important to God no matter where you are or what you're doing. You're important to Him because He created you and He's so excited about who you are. He's thinking about you all the time and He's caring about you all the time because He loves you so much. Can you tell me who made you? That's right, God made you, and that's why you're so important to Him. I want you to remember that all week long and never ever forget how important you are to God. I love you so much and I'll see you next time. Bye!
What's up, everyone? It's another great new day in August, and I'm so glad you're tuning in. I'm sure you all are looking great. It's almost like you were made in God's image. Oh wait, you were. And that means you're full of beauty and goodness and creativity. Here's something else that's really cool about creativity. It has no limits. God's creativity is limitless, which we can see whenever we look at the amazing world God created. Think about it. Have you ever seen the exact same sunset? Sure, there's similarities, but if you look closely, each sunset is different, with different strokes of color. It's like God is painting the sky with unlimited imagination. Or think about clouds. Have you ever noticed how they're never really the same? They're always moving and always changing. In fact, have you ever played the cloud game where you look up and stare at the clouds and try to pick out different figures and shapes? Sometimes they look like animals or they look like mountains. Really all kinds of things. God never runs out of ideas. Let me ask you something before we sing together. Why do we worship God? Think about that for a second. If we were together, I'm sure I would hear lots of different answers, but here's a few to think about. We worship God because God is creative. God's amazing. God's wonderful. And our memory verse this month reminds us of that truth. Remember, it comes from the book of Psalms. It goes like this: Lord, you are great. You are really worthy of praise. No one can completely understand how great you are. Psalm 145:3. Let's say it again together. 3, 2, 1. Lord, you are great. You are really worthy of praise. No one can completely understand how great you are. Psalm 145, 3. Our God is truly indescribable, but like I said last week, that won't keep us from trying. So let's sing out and then hear some great words from the Bible.
Every single storm and every beat of my heart. I just wanna
thank you, cause everything you made is so beautiful. Every single star and every beat of my heart, and it's beautiful.
Here we go, break it down.
Everything you created with your imagination is wonderful and good. You're my inspiration beyond all explanation. You're wonderful and good. You're wonderful.
I just wanna
thank you, cause everything you made is so beautiful. Every single star and every beat of my heart, and it's beautiful. I just wanna thank you, cause everything you made is so beautiful. Every single star and every beat of my heart, and it's beautiful.
The Bible. It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how He created us and loves us so much that He made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now, for an amazing story. Inspired by the book of Esther.
Esther was the queen of Persia.
Wait, what? Queen?
Esther didn't become queen in the usual way. See, her father wasn't a king, and she wasn't from a noble family.
It's just me and cousin Mordecai.
In fact, Esther was Jewish. Many of God's people had been captured and brought to Babylon when their home, Judah, was conquered. Then Babylon was taken over by Persia. So Esther grew up in a land that wasn't her own. When Esther's parents died, her cousin Mordecai raised her as his very own daughter.
Always remember what our scriptures say. Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul. Love him with all your strength.
One day, a new king named Xerxes came to power in Persia. He was so impulsive that he actually fired his queen, Vashti, simply for refusing to show up at a wild party.
She will never see me again.
When Xerxes had finally calmed down, he had realized he now had no queen.
I have no queen.
He would have to find a new one.
I must find a new one.
So the king decided to hold a contest. He ordered his officials to gather the most beautiful young women in the land and put them through an entire year of beauty treatments. Esther was one of those girls chosen.
Cousin Mordecai, what do I do?
Don't tell anyone you're from a Jewish family.
I have chosen my new queen. Drum roll. My new queen is Esther.
Mm-hmm. Me?
Assume the queenly royal crown. I might have to resize it.
Just as Xerxes had so impulsively switched queens, he also promoted a royal official named Haman higher than all of the other nobles in the kingdom.
Bow to me, you fools!
Haman was delighted when all of the officials outside the palace bowed low before him. When he discovered that Mordecai refused to bow, he was enraged.
You have to bow. Somebody make him bow.
Haman was so angry. He made a plan to destroy not only Mordecai, but all the Jews in the land. He laid it out for the king.
Your Majesty, these Jews live differently than everyone else. They don't obey your laws.
Fiddlesticks. That's just wrong.
Precisely. Give the order to destroy them.
Consider it done.
Xerxes agreed to the terrible decree. Messengers took the letter all over the kingdom.
Hear ye, hear ye.
On the 13th day of the 12th month, all Jews are to be killed. Hear ye, hear ye.
When Mordecai and the other Jews discovered the horrible news, they dressed in rough clothing and wept bitterly. Mordecai sent a message to Esther in the palace, telling her what Haman had done.
You must ask the king to save our people.
Esther was devastated. She sent a response to her cousin.
No one can come before the king unless he sends for them. If I do it, I'll die, unless he reaches out his gold scepter to me.
Mordecai sent his answer right back.
You may not escape, even though you're queen. Who knows? It's possible that you became queen for just a time like this.
He's right. Here, tell this to Mordecai. Gather all the Jews. Don't eat anything for 3 days. I and my servants will fast too. Then I'll go to the king.
Esther faced an impossible dilemma, but she took 3 days to prepare her heart and her mind.
Bring my most beautiful royal robes.
Heart racing, Esther entered the throne room. Across the long hall, she saw the king seated high on the throne. Breathless, she waited for him to see her.
Please, please, please.
The king looked up, his dark eyes locked on Esther's face. And then he smiled. He reached out his golden scepter.
Thank God.
What is it, Queen Esther? I'll give you anything, up to half my kingdom.
Esther could have made her request right away, but she knew she would have a better chance if she made the king curious.
King Xerxes, if it pleases you, come to a feast I prepared today. Oh, and bring Haman.
Consider it done.
Esther created an elaborate feast for the king and his number two official.
Look at me, you peasants, invited to the queen's banquet.
At the meal, King Xerxes once again tried to discover what Esther wanted.
I'll give you anything, up to half my kingdom.
Once again, Esther held her ground and waited for the perfect moment.
I'd like you and Haman to come to another feast tomorrow. Then I'll answer your question.
The king agreed, and Haman spent the whole evening bragging to all of his friends.
You guys, the queen thinks I am the bomb.
But the second feast was a different story. As before, Esther prepared an incredible meal. Both Haman and the king were quick to dig in.
What do you want me to do for you? I'll give you up to half my kingdom.
Esther took a deep breath. Something told her this was the right moment.
Your Majesty, let me live. Please spare my people. We have been sold to be destroyed.
Haman paled and choked on his fillet, but the king's face flushed red with rage.
Who is the man who has dared to do such a thing?
Esther turned her gaze on Haman.
Haman is the one.
In a panic, Haman threw himself at the queen.
Totally didn't mean it. Please, please, please let me live. You dare attack the queen? Take him away.
That very night, Haman was killed, and the king created a new order that would allow the Jews to be saved.
We will celebrate this day with great joy.
God had given Esther a surprising position in a foreign nation, and when the time was right, she would use all she had been given to save her people.
Every single one of us is creative. It's not only those who think they're good at art or music or crafts. We can all be creative because every single one of us is made in God's image. That's today's bottom line. God created you so you can be creative. Say that with me, everybody. God created you so you can be creative. God has designed you in a unique way to love God and love others. So let's talk to God and thank Him and ask Him to show us how we can use our creativity. Lord God, we come before you this morning thankful for all that you've created around us, from the sunsets, sunrises, though we don't often see those. Lord, thank you for the clouds, the trees, the ants that walk on the ground, all of it is your creation and it is good. Help us to take part in that creativity, inspire us, and Lord, let us use the creativity that we have for good. Lord, would you walk with us this week? And we pray this in Jesus' name. All God's children said, amen. Thanks for tuning in this week. We will see you next time.